This is a very important topic when we are discussing about child sexual abuse. Though it's a very lengthy topic, it involves 2 days of training, but my aim is just to inform each and every member of Indian Medical Association that what CSA is. CSA is a child sexual abuse, and why it is important, and who is a child. There is a confusion always, the child is up to 12 or 18, but as per as POCSO rule, POCSO is a very important rule. It's a prevention of child sexual abuse. So this, which was introduced by Government of India in 2012. Under POCSO, 18 year is the age of child. Why we should know about child sexual abuse? Because the child sexual abuse has been identified as a very important, as a diagnosis nowadays. And every day you are listening about child sexual abuse. So child sexual abuse is a problem which is to be identified, and it is a preventable. The most important thing is that it is preventable. If you know this is happening, then you can prevent it by informing the public, by informing the parents, by informing the teachers. And why it is important that everybody should be informed, that the child sexual abuse can take place anywhere. Most important is at home, in the places where the child is going, like the schools, at the places where child is being protected, like children home. So these are the areas where everybody should be aware of how to identify the child sexual abuse and what can be the reason of child sexual abuse. And child sexual abuse is commonly being perpetrated by a person very well known to a child. Why? Because the child, if suppose he complains to the parents, they will not listen, because someone is very close to the family who is perpetrating the crime. So one has to identify. And the most important thing when we are talking about the diagnosis, then why you should listen to your kids. And most of the times, if child is complaining about abuse to the parents against a person who is very close to the family is not ready to listen. Because we are in habit of saying, you are not telling the truth, you are wrong. So first notion should disappear from our mind that it is a very common disease. And why one should identify, and what is very important for doctors, under POCSO it is important, mandatory, to report child sexual abuse to the authorities like police. Because this is mandatory, and if you fail to report child sexual abuse, then imprisonment for 6 months is very much likely. So everybody should be aware about the POCSO rule and the importance of mandatory reporting. And when mandatory reporting is there, then there is a treatment is also mandatory for you to provide. So sometimes there is a problem of mandatory reporting, and sometimes you have to protect the identity of the child, as well as even the treatment is to be very secretive. And there is a problem when you talk about MTP with such cases. The MTP, everything is to be secretive. You should not inform to anyone. And child sexual abuse is a mandatory reporting. So there are two contradictions which everybody should be aware about. So why it is important, everybody should know. And it is the responsibility of a doctor to protect a child. And sometimes what is very important is we fail to even examine such child sexual abuse kids, because the things never comes to our mind. And then when we think that it is a child sexual abuse, then we will wait for some authority to ask us to conduct examination, which is absolutely not required. If you suspect even a case of a child sexual abuse, the examination is very important, and you have to do it without any reference from police or from court or from anybody. That is very important. And there are two very important things about the consent. When consent is required for examination, investigation and treatment, it is up to the age of 12 years you have to take a consent of a parent, or you have to take a consent of a person who is really confident of a child. And from 12 to 18, the consent is to be taken of the victim. You do not require consent from parents or anybody close to the child, but the child consent from 12 to 18 is very important. So these few things are very important, and everybody should be in a position to identify child sexual abuse, because if it is not identified at the early age, then the result at the end of childhood is very bad, because the psychological trauma is so bad in such cases that they can never recover from such trauma. So it is to be identified at the early age, it is to be diagnosed, it is to be treated by all means, whether it is a physical injury is to be treated immediately, if it is a psychological trauma it is to be treated. If you miss any one of them, then the child will have a lot of problems. And for this kind of a situation, it is required that there should be a center in a hospital where child can be examined, can be treated and can be consoled. So it is expected that a center should be created where the pediatrician, the gynecologist, the forensic expert and the psychiatrist all should be under one roof, and they can talk to the child once and start the treatment, whatever is required. And the important thing is then in child sexual abuse, in most of the cases, only in 1/3 of the cases you will find some positive findings. In 2/3 of the cases there is no positive finding of injury, but with the history, with the treatment, you have to diagnose and you have to write it down in black and white that this is the history and this is the treatment the child has been given, and it proves that it is a case of child sexual abuse. It is not that the physical trauma or injuries should be there only, then only you will confirm. And this is what is the most important point when we are diagnosing child sexual abuse, rather even in rape cases also. The forensic expert says that 2/3 of the cases you will not find any positive finding. Even you may not find even a semen positive test. So these things one has to keep it in mind and try to diagnose child sexual abuse, which has become a very common identity in a pediatric age group. And we should be aware about child sexual abuse, POCSO, and we should be sure that it can be prevented at all levels if we inform the public as well as the family as well as the places, the schools and teachers about the sexual behavior and what is good touch and what is bad touch. These things are going to be very helpful in preventing child sexual abuse. Thank you.
Sir, I would like to bring